actually the Ministry of Education officers are required to do is to implement policies on Wellington. Wellington policy, Ministry of Education regional offices implement them. Schools have to comply. This is a centralized system we have. This is what is happening right now. We have a system where regional offices are simply having to implement the government, the Ministry of Education's operation in schools. And that, of course, is why principals and schools are so frustrated in the Ministry of Education, and they complain about bureaucracy, because the Ministry of Education actually has not got a role in the legal framework to support schools. Because the Crown Agency or the trustees. So, and the last point, I think I've put a picture there, the last point, and I'm sort of incredulous when I think about this. I'm incredulous. That what we have is we create a system that provides really very limited support for teachers and principals. Professional support. It's sort of up to the boards. And teachers in here will know when they try to access professional development, it is a nightmare of compliance. We have no mechanisms to actually provide an advisory service, a professional curriculum, assessment, pedagogy, the real stuff that teachers do. There is nothing there, or very little. And it's the same thing with principals. I talk to principals all the time. Many principals are stressed to the limits. The job they have is enormous. What leadership advice do we provide them? Hardly any. What support do we provide them? Hardly any. Because we have a system that doesn't allow that mechanism to operate. Boards of trustees are crammed with the need. And we've taken that a little bit. It's not there. So it's no wonder, I think, teachers feel undervalued about it. Because really, they're on their own, they have to think for themselves. So this, I'm describing this because I believe this state of affairs that we have, this current, what we have now, does not, as system, make. It is not a system. It is a devolved process where 2,500 independent entities that are going to sort it out. We do not have a system. And for us, if you look around the world, this system is not replicated anywhere in the world. This system is not a sensible system, and we need to change it. I'm absolutely clear that in some schools it's possible for all that good stuff to happen, but what I'm asking you to do in this hall right now is think about all the schools in this country, and we're a small country, and think about how we can support all the children in this country. So, I want to move to the rest, and you're going to stop me if I go on too long. I'm going to be a bit more than that. The recommendations we're talking about, first of all, we want to focus the role of the Board of Trustees. We think Boards of Trustees are critically important. We think community input is critically important. We want to focus it on what boards want to do. But we said around the annual plan and the strategic plan, the school rules, school procedures, what kind of curriculum delivery there is, what's the uniqueness, what's the character of this school. That's what we want all the trustees to do. So when people say that we're taking the uniqueness out of schools, we just don't see that. We want boards to continue and focus what they do. What we're also saying, however, is that boards need to maintain their authority in terms of the appointment of the principal. So we put that in together. In a shared role, the boards will have the authority to veto and approve the appointment of the school principal. We're not taking that away from boards. And we're saying to principals, the money you currently have, the autonomy you currently have, the operational funds you get, you keep. You have full discretion on that. The staffing entitlement you have, you keep. No discretion, absolute discretion on that. So when I hear people say somewhere on the line that this centralisation of principals are going to have to come up to get permission to do stuff, is a load of nonsense. What we are saying is principals retain the autonomy for their staffing, for their operational funds. This is a New Zealand.